We kick off the show with a look at how European markets are trading right now. Bourses in the region have made a U-turn as they move cautiously higher in midday trade after an open in the red. Investors in Europe reacting to China's consumer inflation rate, which was flat in June, while factory gate prices fell further, fueling deflation worries, but also adding speculation about a potential stimulus. As for Wall Street, futures for the major indices are flat, while 10-year Treasury yields jump. Investors there are bracing for comments from several Fed officials as well as the start of the second quarter earnings season. U.S. inflation data also due on Wednesday.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of American multinational tech firm NVIDIA. That's after investment bank Barclays acknowledged that hardware giants are currently capturing the immediate economic benefits of the use of AI. NVIDIA shares are kicking off trade at a little over $425 each. Also in focus, shares of French engineering firm GTT. It announced last week it had received several orders from Samsung Heavy Industries for the tank design for five new liquefied natural gas or LNG carriers. Shares of GTT surged around 5% in midday trade. We're also keeping a close watch on German digital marketplace Scout24, whose shares plunged after UBS issued a sell rating for the stock. Shares of Scout24 are currently trading at 54.10 euros. And finally, we'll also be looking at shares of Total Energies. The French oil giant signed a $27 billion energy deal with Iraq, aimed at boosting the country's capacity to produce energy with four oil, gas, and renewables projects. Shares of Total Energies are trading nearly 1% higher at 51.57 euros apiece.
Asian markets ended today's trade on a mixed note following the unexpected Chinese inflation report. Hong Kong and mainland shares booked gains on stimulus hopes. Japan's Nikkei 225, meanwhile, closed 0.6% lower, extending its losses to 5 days, while Australia's ASX 200 fell to its lowest in over 3 months. Some notable stock movements in the region, shares of Alibaba and Tencent surged as investors bet China's tech crackdown is over. That's after regulators fined Alibaba affiliate Ant Group nearly $1 billion on Friday, ending a years-long regulatory overhaul of the fintech company. Here at home, Philippine shares closed flat, still on very anemic volume. Regina Capital's Jerry Alfonso says the market trend remains bearish amid persistent economic growth concerns.
Market players are still risk-off, and they are probably cutting their losses or moving on fixed income or staying in cash. We could probably see some action or volatility with the upcoming earnings season, and hopefully this will drive the markets volume heavy.
Here are some local corporate headlines. First Gen Corporation awards the contract for its first liquefied natural gas cargo to Shell Eastern LNG. Shell Eastern LNG will supply FGen with cargo worth over 150,000 cubic meters between August and September for FGen's gas-fired plants in Batangas. FGen shares closed up 1% at 19 pesos and 82 centavos apiece. Meanwhile, Philinvest REIT Corporation seeks to add over 12,000 square meters in new leases on top of over 10,000 square meters of leases signed this year. The company says it is in advanced talks with two BPO tenants as well as co-working facility operators and new BPO firms. The company shares jumped over 6% in today's trade. And Boulevard Holdings, the company behind the Friday's Resorts, posts a 34% year-on-year sales growth in its Puerto Galera branch. This is worth around 2.5 million pesos. BHI shares close flat at around 7 centavos apiece.